And welcome to Virtual Church. Here we are again, another Sunday. Another theme is Christ the King today. Rejoice, the Lord is King, your Lord and King adore. Really wonderful way to open this festal service, this festal occasion, the week before Advent. So that was a request from David and Cheryl, patrons. So thank you very much indeed for your requests. We're going to crack on, because I'm really in the mood for some really good Christ the King hymns. Christ the King. Well, let's go into Crown Him with Many Crowns. There aren't many hymns which are better for Christ the King than this one. The tune is called Diademater. That almost caught me out. Maybe it did catch me out. And it's by George Elvey and is a request from Tristan, Patreon. Hello, Tristan, Donna and Sean. Please do say hello in the chat. Please do let us all know where you're from and all of that. It was really, really wonderful to know whereabouts in the world you are. So whilst you're doing that, whilst you're saying hello, I said my hellos, you say hello now back. Let's crack on with Crown Him with Many Crowns, the Lamb upon His Throne.
Thank you. Julian.
Thank you all very much for joining me last night for the organ recital. Those of you who are with us today and those of you who were with us last night, I really appreciate you joining us. It's really wonderful to look back through the chat and see familiar names, so thank you very much for your support. I will be going through the answers to the quiz today. We'll go through the answers to the quiz later on in the virtual church. We've marked all your answers, some very, very good efforts actually, and we've come up with the top three. Okay, so we'll probably do that at the end. The next hymn is, Great is thy faithfulness, O God of my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thank you very much to Julian for requesting this. So three verses of this wonderful uplifting hymn, Great is thy faithfulness. What we're really interested is about today, with it being Christ the King, I really want to see if there are some hymns that you suggest, which I've never really considered to be associated to Christ the King, otherwise known, as I gather, called Stir Up Sunday, which is either because one of the collects starts with those words, or actually people start stirring up their Christmas pudding. Whatever, whichever one it is, it's an uplifting occasion, and the voluntary will reflect that. So wait for the voluntary. Next hymn for Hank, he was one of our patrons. I should also say that Julian before that was also a patron. Is Thy Kingdom Come on Bended Knee, The Passing Ages Pray. Five verses of this by Frederick Hosmer, of the words. And the tune is actually called Irish. Okay, so Hank has requested this. Hank is over in the Netherlands, where this organ is located. He was very lucky to have access to some very, very fine organs indeed over there. Can't wait to see you. So here we go. Thy Kingdom Come, on Bended Knee, The Passing Ages Pray. Okay, so the next one is a bit confusing. I can't really work out what I need to do here. I've got two different tunes, I think, to the same words. Hail, Redeemer, King Divine, Priest and Lamb, the throne is thine. A tune requested by Jerry in this wonderful Irish hymn book, the Veritas Hymnal. And then also a request for the tune, it's called King Divine by Charles Rigby. So what I guess I'll do is, as there are, let's have a look. How does it work? I'm not really sure. So there's a refrain. Okay. What I'll do is I'll basically segue from one tune to the next, if that's okay. They're in different keys. C major to A major. Not a million miles away, I suppose. So King Divine is the tune in A major, and the tune in the Veritas hymnal is called Rex. So Jerry and Morris, both of whom are patrons, have asked for the same words but different tunes, so I'll see what I can do. think that would have left the congregation well and truly baffled as to what on earth was going on. But we have the two hymns there, requested by two people, same words, but the different tunes. Hope you managed to work out what I was doing there. I gather it's Thanksgiving next week in USA. I just hadn't quite clicked with the dates, so in advance of that, we should actually think what we're going to do for Thanksgiving. I'll think of something to give you on the channel. We gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chastens and hastens his will to make known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name. He forgets not his own. Thank you very much to Nameless One. That's a very descriptive name, isn't it? Daniel Tom, who's a patron, and Victoria. This is obviously quite a popular one. So at least five people there. Nameless One, Daniel, Tom, Victoria. Four even. I think we've had this before on the channel. The music is called Kremza. And its words are by Theodore Baker. Oh, sorry, the words were actually not by Theodore Baker. They were translated by him from words from the 17th century. Doesn't say what language they were in originally. So here we go, three verses of We Gather Together to Ask the Lord's Blessing. That all seemed over very quickly, actually. Maybe it was too fast. I hope it wasn't too fast. It was possibly a little bit too fast. I should have probably played that a little fraction slower. I do hope that you're all okay. I do hope that you're all well. I can't believe we are nearly in Advent. Next week we're in Advent. Next week we'll have a big service, a big virtual church. Lots of Advent stuff. That's really, really exciting. Lots of organ music, lots of hymns. So one or two things going on the channel before that as well, actually. And I'll announce those in the week. I hope you've let Caroline know where you're all from in the world. I'd love to know how far reaching we are. I'd love to be able to get to every single corner. So all for Jesus, this our song shall ever be. For we have no hope nor saviour if we have not hope in thee. This is a wonderful tune by John Stainer, and the tune is called All for Jesus, and it has been requested by John, one of our patrons. Hello, if you're a new patron, I had a few new patrons join over the weekend. You are very welcome, and I'm very, very grateful for your support and a contribution towards the channel. Okay, so here we go for John. All for Jesus, all for Jesus. Played the Amen at the end there is because this hymn was originally written for the, he wrote an oratorio in English called Crucifixion. I don't know whether the prefixes it or not. I think it's called The Crucifixion. I don't know. That is the final hymn in that wonderful oratorio, and it's just such an uplifting end, I suppose, a very positive and reassuring end to an otherwise pretty grim story. And very positive hymn ends with the most almighty Amen at the end on that plagal cadence. It's a really, really spectacular and very poignant moment indeed, actually. You know, the Bach Matthew Passion ends on that wonderful, in that wonderful chord at the end. And that's it. The St. John Passion ends with a hymn, a chorale, but the Stainer ends with the hymn, but it's just it's such a wonderfully reassuring hymn. Okay, so the next hymn here is, "We know that Christ is raised and dies no more. Embraced by death, he broke its fearful hold." This is actually the wonderful tune by Charles Villiers Stanford, the Irish composer, called Engelberg. It's a wonderful tune, this. Wonderful tune indeed. This is one of my favourite tunes. It's not sung as often as it ought to be, I don't think. There are four verses, and it goes through fairly quickly, actually. So if you can keep up, that would be really good. So this is for Josh, who is one of our patrons. I think I probably gave you an extra verse there, but I was enjoying that music so much. And there was one bar, for some reason, I couldn't play. You know when you get yourself into a bit of a pickle? And I've heard even the best organists, way better than me, do the same thing in a hymn, which is otherwise largely straightforward. Just do silly things, the same thing over and over again in each verse. It just becomes a bit of a mental block. This bit. From that chord of C major first inversion to G major 7, major into a minor. It's a wonderful tune by a standard. We're just gonna have a little bit of a break from hymns and have a bit of Paul Mann's. I actually released an organ album recently featuring five pieces by Paul Mann's, and they are all of these. I recorded them all on five different organs. It's on the channel, go and check it out. They're all rather good, actually. Can't remember which organ I used for this one. It was possibly Rotterdam, actually, because it ends very loudly, and Rotterdam does a lot of things loudly, but it does a lot of things well, should I say, but it does loud particularly well. So this is Paul Mann's arrangement of Now Thank We All Our God, Nun Danket Alle Gott, of course. Thank you very much to Ship's Bells for requesting this and actually for making this possible. Okay, so there's a fiddly bar or two in this, so I just need to keep my wits about me. Maybe Caroline will turn a page for this, because I can't turn this page without to the detriment of missing out some notes. So Now Thank We All Our God by Paul Mann's in a funky organ chorale arrangement. Thank you. It was my intention to play that at just a slightly slower speed. Because I remember when I recorded it, which was one or two bars, I had to work out the fingering. And just having not practiced this or played this since I made that recording a few weeks ago, I just thought, as I'm live, I thought I would just knock the edge off the tempo a little bit so I can remember how it goes. So that was Paul Manzer's Now Thank We All Our God. Thank you very much, Ships Bells, for requesting that, and indeed for making that possible. I'm just going to click on my mouse just for a moment. I hope you don't mind. I'm going to try and multitask here. Those of you who are techies and a bit geeky like me, Caroline wants to change the angles and she's not able to do it. It's simply because the software that we're using, OBS, I mentioned that in that video that we did a few weeks ago, OBS needs to be in the foreground for the angles to change. I can change them on this Stream Deck here, but Caroline can't use her QWERTY keyboard with the one with the masking tape all over it. So what I need to do is, there we go, make it so OBS, it needs to be in the foreground for it to work. It wasn't, unfortunately, but now, Caroline, just try it now. There we go, see, it works now. Yeah, it's a little bit of behind the scenes sort of how we do things here. So the next hymn, let's crack on into the next hymn. After all, that's what you're here for. Jesus shall reign wherever the sun does his successive journeys run. His kingdom stretch from shore to shore till moons shall wax and wane no more. The tune is called Truro. And it's for Lord Byron. Thank you very much for requesting this. Thank you. This is the hymn book, which I, for some reason, a few weeks ago, decided to sniff and noted that it smelt American. I have no idea what I meant by that. It just smells like old church. So this hymn book was sent by one of our patrons. I think it was Terry, from America. So it's come all the way over the Atlantic. It's well travelled, this hymn book. Well travelled indeed. Now, I'd like to know, Terry, where was this hymn book? Where did it used to be? Did it used to be in a church? Did it used to sit in the choir cupboard? Was it on the pew in the church itself? Who's held this hymn book? Who's held this hymn book? Let us know. Give me a bit of, I like to imagine things. The next hymn is Evening and, from this hymn book, Evening and Morning, Sunset and Dawning, Wealth, Peace and Gladness, Comfort in Sadness. These are thy works, all the glory be thine. Three verses of this. Three verses. It looks like it's a wonderful hymn from the, well, it is from the 17th century. Not by a composer that I know. Johann George Eberling. I think that's German, so. Okay, so here we go then. Three verses for Terry, one of our patrons. It does say here in the tempo, cheerfully. So we'll make sure we play it cheerfully. Thank you very much, Terry, for that. That's a good hymn. Never played it before, never heard it before. Thank you very much for bringing that to my attention and to, no doubt to a lot of other people's attention as well. Okay, the next hymn here is, I think I had this a couple of weeks ago, and it was the one where there was a deskhand to verse 3, but I'm not sure I'm going to be able to do it. I could give it a go, I suppose. King of glory, King of peace, I will love thee, and that love may never cease, I will move thee. Of course, it's the famous words by George Herbert, but the tune here is different. The tune is actually by David Charles Walker, born in 1938. So, let's see how we get on with this. This is for Jay, who's one of our patrons. Hi, Jay. King of glory, King of peace, I will love thee. Make sure you stick around for the quiz answers, by the way. I'll be doing those answers later on in the show. I think we had over 20 entries and some very, very good attempts. No one got full marks, though, so maybe the quiz was a little bit too difficult. I thought it was quite easy, actually. King of glory, King of peace, I would love thee. Of course, the words by George Herbert. Really rather nice tune, actually. The final verse there, the descant on the clarinet, is an optional descant sung by a tenor or soprano. Obviously that was a soprano pitch. Rather nice tune. Thank you very much, Jay, for requesting that one. It's nice to play tunes, actually, which aren't the usual tunes. The next one here, there's a wideness in God's mercy like the wideness of the sea. The tune here is called Corvedale. It's for Martin, who is over in the Netherlands. We have a few people actually in the Netherlands. We do want to come over to the Netherlands very soon to come and say hello and actually to hear these spectacular organs in real life. There's a lot of organs out there. And we actually have a reason potentially to come over to the Netherlands very soon. So more on that in the future. Okay, so there's a wideness in God's mercy. This is a hymn where you have to be careful for the final verse. Verse 4 is only half a verse, and it starts halfway through the verse in the music. So what I've done He's actually put a little tick next to where I need to move my eyes to find out where on earth I'm supposed to go. Okay, so thank you very much, Martin. Here we go, 3.5 verses of There's a Wideness in God's Mercy. Just a wonderful tune. Thank you very much, Martin. That's a great, great hymn. We've had really good hymns today. Keep it up, guys. Keep up the good work with all of these wonderful hymns. It is, after all, Christ the King, isn't it? So let's just keep it as Christ the King-like as possible. To me, that's just a celebration. Celebration that the Christ is above everyone else. He is the King. He reigns supreme. The strife is over. The battle done. Now is the victor's triumph won. Oh, let the song of praise be sung. Alleluia. I wonder whether Mr. Rawsthorne has done a cheeky last verse of this. It's very, very short. We haven't had a Noel Rawsthorne yet today. Do you know what? He has. Look at that. Well, no idea what it's like, but let's see what it's like live, shall we, all together. So the strife is o'er. Sounds like a Yorkshireman, that. The strife is o'er, battle won. Now it's victor's triumph won. Oh, let song of praise be sung. Alleluia. That's my best Yorkshire accent. I'm not from Yorkshire, I'm from Derbyshire. There's a bit of a difference. Okay, so here we go. Here we go, for OB Composer, otherwise known as Ollie. Verse 4 is rather spectacular. He break the age-bound chains of hell. The bars from heaven's high portals fell. Let hymns of praise his triumph tell. Alleluia. He break the age-bound chains of hell. So, have that really monstrous, menacing sound that these reeds on this organ can produce. Hopefully gave you that image of hell and all of that sort of stuff. Then it broke away. Thank you, Obi. I think that that last verse was actually rather restrained, actually. I was expecting something for the final Alleluia to be completely out there. Actually, it was rather restrained. Oh, yes. Time to just pop into communion, perhaps. The King of Love, my Shepherd, is his goodness faileth never. This is a wonderful tune, St. Columba. Quiet one, this one. This is a very quiet one. It is, of course, the way you say it, it is based on Psalm 23. So verse where, presumably, yeah, verse 4, in death's dark veil I fear no ill, with thee, dear Lord, beside me. Let's just try and find a really suitable sound for a dark veil. Where death may be. Okay, so six verses of this, requested by Mark and Jared, both of whom are Patreons. Thank you very much, guys. We are at, last time I looked, was 217, and that is just phenomenal. Thank you very much to everyone who has supported the channel over the past months, and people who have become Patreons. It really does help, it really does help. I'm talking into a camera and a lens right this second, paid for by the support this channel gets. The camera overlooking my shoulder here was also made possible by the patrons, the generosity of patrons. If we can get to 220 today, it really helps everything. Just it really helps the content, the quality, and everything else. Okay, so Mark and Jared, for you, the King of Love, my Shepherd is. Thank you. beautiful tune. I think you'll all agree. Just a little bit of a palate cleanser, wasn't it, after the previous hymn, which is a bit exciting. So thank you very much to Mark and to Jared, both of whom requested that one. It was a really interesting stream last night. It was a bit unfortunate that it coincided with my recital, but there was a live video, a live stream from Sassel Peace, where Daniel Roth demonstrated the organ live, and it was really quite amazing, really. He really, people were able to suggest live in the chat, just like you're doing now with the hymns. They were suggesting registrations, and one of the registrations I think that was requested was the Celestes and a Nazard. So that's what the Celestes on the swell and the Nazard sounds like on this organ. It was rather good. Okay, so we'll go into the next hymn now, which is over here in the UK. This is just definitely a harvest hymn. It's synonymous with harvest. But over in the States, I think this is actually it's another celebratory hymn. Well, it is a celebration, and harvest and Christ the King are both celebrations. So what I've done is I fished out the El Rawthorn. There's quite a lot of notes in that one actually. And we might have that, we might not. We'll see how we feel. We plough the fields and scatter the good seed on the land, but it is fed and watered by God's almighty hand. Thank you very much to William, who is one of our patrons, and also to Herbert, who is over in Uganda. So it's very good to have, of course, to have you both with us. I'm not aware of being told that we have had anyone from Uganda before, so you are very, very welcome indeed. Hello. Presumably, are these hymns ones that you recognise? Do you have the same sort of hymns over in Uganda as we do here in the UK? I'd be very interested to know that. Okay, so here we go. We plough the fields and scatter the good seed on the land, etc., etc. You know the words to this one, with a little bit of know-all at the end, possibly. So that one does actually stray away from the original harmony quite a bit towards the end, particularly. He's obviously feeling a little bit outrageous when he wrote that one. Maybe he had a few cocktails by that point. You know, it's really wonderful actually. I'll let you into a little secret, and I hope the person in question doesn't mind. But actually, we have at least one member of the Rawsthorne family who joins you in the congregation, albeit silently. The sort of person just to sit, come in late, sit at the back, and slip out early, perhaps. It's very, very humbling and very nice to have someone who knew Noel very well, and just to give, to pass on one or two anecdotes about how these were, how these came to be. That's one of the reasons why I like playing them, actually, because it means something. They are sentimental, and actually they're rather good. Talking about sentimentality, it is someone's in the chat, Edward and Laura. It is their 58th wedding anniversary today. So a huge congratulations to you guys for 58 years. Here's to another 58 years. Edward and Laura walked down the aisle to this Jeremiah Clark, the Prince of Denmark's March. You all know this. You all know it without a doubt. And then they walked out to Purcell, trumpet tune, which you will all know, I'm sure. These are two of the most famous trumpet tunes, I think, in existence. So let's just have a little bit of a Christ the King celebration with two uplifting trumpet tunes for Edward and Laura. So congratulations to you guys. I hope this brings back suitable and happy memories of Laura, you walking down the aisle with your bridal party, and then you both walking out at the end. Hope that was okay for you. Wonderful, two wonderful trumpet tunes. There, for you. So, happy anniversary to you. Happy 58th anniversary. I hope you've, Edward, I hope you've treated Laura today. Okay, so I was just wondering actually, there's a funny, something quirky has happened. I don't know why that's happened at all. It's very, very strange. But if I, when I press swell 6, which you organists should know this, if I press swell 6, that should only impact the swell stops. Okay, we're all in agreement with that. It shouldn't change anything else. For some reason, when I press 6, it's pulling out stops on all the divisions, as well as the couplers, which is why occasionally the chamades are ending up on the manuals where they ought not to be. Why on earth has that happened? That's very, very irritating indeed. What I'm going to have to do is just, let me just see if I can just fix that. I think I might have just fixed it. Okay, yes, 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 set. Very odd. I don't know what happened there. Okay, so it's Edward and Laura. Very happy wedding anniversary to you. Where were you married? What church were you in? Whereabouts were you? Okay, so this gives a bit of context around that. All hail the power of Jesus' name. Let angels prostrate fall. Bring forth royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. Okay, Donna and Dennis, this is for you, especially for you. Thank you very much to anyone who may have donated in the chat. I think someone did donate earlier on. If you are still around, thank you very much indeed for that. It's very, very generous of you indeed. You are able to send really quirky stickers. I don't know why, but YouTube chose to animate the stickers with pears. Animated pears of all things. I've heard of bananas and pajamas and, you know, but I've never heard of dancing pears before. But they're rather funny. So if you're able to send, Caroline's just given me some very healthy apricots here, but I think like you guys, I prefer a bit of cake actually. So maybe a bit of cake might be appreciated. If you can find an emoji for cake, that would be wonderful. Okay, Donna and Dennis, all hail the power of Jesus.
Thank you.
very kind, Lisa. Thank you very much for that cake. I will pretend that I'm eating that cake with one of these dried apricots. We actually have cake next door, which Caroline made just a few days ago, the Victoria sponge. So you guys actually talk about cake a lot, but actually this time I have cake. I have real cake that I can enjoy whilst you guys are either teasing me by saying you're baking cake or making a Christmas pudding, talking about custard and all that sort of random stuff. So thank you very much, Lisa. Thank you very much also to Paul for your donation. Paul, you know what we spoke about on email with regard to certain repertoire of a composer. It's coming very soon. It's in the process. Okay, so all hail the power of Jesus' name. Let angels prostrate fall. We just had these words. And crown him. Crown him. Crown him. Crown him. The refrain is rather sort of raucous, really. You just have this crown him repeated over again. It's in 3-4. So it's crown him. Rest. Crown him. Rest. Crown him. And just imagine someone sort of shouting, crown him. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun, actually. I'll try and make it sound like fun. The tune is called Diadem. It's not one that we have in this country. I think this is one that is familiar over in the States. So we have. It's been requested by a few people. Roger, who was a patron. Hi, Roger. Chris, another patron, and Countdown to Show. An interesting name, isn't it? Countdown to Show. What show is that? Okay, four verses, guys, of this wonderfully uplifting and rather comical hymn. In a good way, I mean. find that one comical like I find it comical. I just find it, I just love the refrain. I love the idea that everyone, the altos and sopranos are sort of doing this. Very beautiful lyrical indeed. But we, meanwhile, the gents are just going, crown him, crown him. A congregation just sort of getting, just turning to chaos with that. It's involved, isn't it? That's what makes it so much fun, is just everyone's getting involved. Thank you very much, Jared, for another slice of cake. What sort of cake was that? I've had two slices of cake now, as well as my dried apricots. I'm going to have to go back on a diet on Monday. That's very kind. And thank you, Katrina, for sending another cat. We've actually now got three cats. We've got our two over here. Nala and Bobby. Actually, we've got Lottie and Finzi here. But now we've got a cat on the virtual church as well. We should name the cat. Let's just pause for a moment and see if we can think of a cat. This next hymn is Wolvercoat. It's quite a good name for a cat, actually, isn't it? Wolvercoat. Jesus, I have promised to serve thee to the end. Thank you very much to Smooth Silk. And thank you for explaining what smooth silk means to you as well. I thank you for your email. Four verses of this, it's wonderful. Lots of passing notes, lots of, it's very involved. The words are by John Bode, and the music is by William Ferguson. And it's to be sung in unison, please. See what I mean about that one being involved? There's lots of passing notes. Actually, it's a as an organ scholar and as a young organist, that's probably one of the hardest hymns, actually, to keep the melody smooth for everything that's going on in the inner parts. Okay, so let's crack on to familiar words. Possibly familiar words. I worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness, bow down before him, glory proclaim. Yes, they are familiar. With gold of obedience and incense of lowliness, kneel and adore him, the Lord, the Lord is his name. The reason I say, is it familiar, is because there are normally four verses plus verse five is the same as verse one, isn't it? But I've only got two verses here. We'll do four verses rather than having two verses. It's not to the tune that we will know over here in the in England. It's a different tune. And I'm not quite sure what the tune is called. It doesn't say on this bit of paper. So don't forget that I'll give you the answers to the infamous quiz that we did last week. Probably just over an hour's time. We'll go through them all, give you the answers, and then we'll... I've also prepared a few more clips, video clips, just to sort of... Let's just prove my point in one or two of the answers. Okay, so here we go. Alan, one of our patrons. Hello, Alan. I worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
Thank you.
Sorry about my sneeze there. Thank you very much for blessing me. A good job the microphones weren't open. Thank you very much, Alan, for requesting that. That's very good of you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much to Nick as well for sending a hot dog through. I think it was the hot dog that set me off, actually. There's a little bit of chili on the hot dog, and I think I just, maybe as I was smelling it, got a little bit overexcited and just inhaled some of the chili. Thanks, Nick. That's very, very kind of you. Also, thank you very much to Mum. Hi, Mum, and Garrett, who also have donated in the chat. It does go a long way. Okay, so nun dankets alle Gott again. This time we've had the Paul Mann's version. We're now going to go into the a little more well-known version, the Karg Alert, March Triumphale. This is a lot of people's favourite piece. Right, so it is. It's uplifting, and it's rather good. You know, the tune keeps coming back round. You have to listen to this piece very, very carefully for the tune. You know, the tune is, of course. But here it's well hidden, so you have sort of this sort of thing going on. Actually, there is on the top. Listen now. So I'll make it legato. That's the tune is there, and then it goes on a bit, and then the next bit. So listen very carefully for the tune. So. This is Nun Dankert, alle Gott. It works rather well on this organ. As I said earlier, this organ does loud very well. But I'll save some of the volume until later on. So let's get some of the mixtures. So Nun Dankert, alle Gott by Siegfried Karg Alert.
Thank you.
jolly uplifting, that piece, isn't it? And there's a sort of piece that you just have to play on. It wouldn't work on a chamber organ, for example. You have to play it on a Rotterdam or something else like that. I wonder what that would sound like at Caen, actually, on the Cavalier Call. That would sound good there, wouldn't it? Maybe that could be a future video. Okay, so I'd like to play a few more organ pieces before we get to the close of today's service. So if you have any more requests for organ music, Christ the King, appropriate organ pieces, please do let us know quickly. Come ye sinners, poor and needy, weak and founded, sick and sore, Jesus ready stands to save you, full of pity, love and power. Ben, thank you very much for requesting this. Another Patreon. Tune is called, I think the tune's called Arise. I think that's the tune. Possibly written by, I don't know, there's sort of names and random sort of titles scattered around this bit of paper. I don't know what is what. It says Joseph Hart, 1759. I don't know whether that's the composer of the music or the composer of the words. I don't know. There's also William Walker. Now, William Walker over in England saved Winchester Cathedral. Do you know that story about William Walker? If you don't, let us know, and I'll quickly tell you after the next hymn in the next link. So, Ben, thank you very much for your support and being a Patreon. Here you are. Come ye sinners, poor and needy. Thank you very much, Ben, for requesting that. I gather you now know who William Walker is. Not, I guess it's a different person who was associated to this. He may have been, he may have written the words, or he may have written the music, I don't know. But I suspect it was a different person. So, good, you know who William Walker is now. So, next hymn, very short, four verses, but actually they're short verses. excuse me, this happened in the recital yesterday. I had a tickle in my throat as I was talking, and I couldn't quite shift this tickle. It's come back again. Good Christians, all rejoice and sing. Now is the triumph of our King. To all the world glad news we bring. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Daniel, this one is for you. Wonderful tune, this. And I wonder whether, could you find it in there, please, Caroline? Mm. Just a little bit of a just a reminder that yesterday I did do a recital, and a little bit of a sort of a chance for me to advertise it to you. Caroline did sing some plain song in it. Please do go back and watch that. If you'd like to hear Caroline sing, she sings beautiful plain song. Well, actually it's a tone for the Magnificat in a piece by Samuel Scheidt. Take it in turns. She does a verse, I do a verse, she does a verse, I do a verse. Luckily, the technology worked okay and it all came over pretty well. So I'd like you to go and watch that. If you just watch that one bit, that would be great. Okay, Daniel, so here we go. Good Christians all rejoice and sing.
Thank you.
Cheers, Daniel. Hope that was all right. I hope the extra harmonies in the end, last verse, didn't put you off your singing. Next verse. Next verse? The next piece will be actually a little ditty from water music. It's called Coro. It's not actually one that is often heard. Oh, maybe it is, actually. Maybe it is. So, Eddie has asked for something from Water Music by Handel. I shall oblige. Play this. You know, the famous bit from the Water Music is known this one. This one is... Well, it's called Coro. I don't know anything more about it than that, I'm afraid. Sorry. It looks like it's rather fun. Let's see how it goes. A bit of sight reading for me. Doesn't look too hard. It's just larger D major and A major. I love the idea of the Water Music, the first performance. Just imagine zooming back into the 18th century in London, central London, down the River Thames. You wouldn't recognise it, would you? You would not recognise if you were if you went back in your TARDIS. Or used your flux capacitor, went back, people just would not recognise the landscape at all. But you have to imagine that the Thames, for a start, was much wider than it is now. It was much, much wider than it is now. And I guess a lot dirtier. And some boats were sailing down the River Thames, playing this music, presumably as it went past Westminster. Don't know whether that was, someone will help me out here, I haven't quite got my dates in order. Whitehall Palace obviously used to be one of the King's residences before it became Buckingham Palace. I'm not sure when Whitehall Palace burnt down. Maybe as the boats were sailing past Whitehall Palace, this is what was played. Anyway, Water Music by Handel for Eddie, one of our patrons. I wish there was more to that. I wish it wasn't one page with repeats. I just wish it went on with the same sort of idea and the same motifs. Thank you very much, Eddie. Hope that was okay. Let's crack on with another hymn, shall we? How good is the God we adore, our faithful, unchangeable friend, whose love is as great as his power and neither knows measure nor end. Actually, the tune is called Celeste. Now, two verses. Now, actually, it looks like the tune comes from Lancashire Sunday School Songs in 1857. Two verses, like I say, words by Joseph Hart. Thank you very much, Nick, another one of our patrons, for requesting this. What should I do? Should I settle about the tune on just a very straightforward 8 and 4 and Nazar down on the lower division, accompanied by, I'll have two flutes on the swell, 16 and 8 on the pedal. That'll give us a clue as to how the tune is meant to go. Well, Nick, I think you've won the prize there. I think that is officially the shortest hymn that we've ever had in Virtual Church. Two verses, that's all there was. So, prize is just an imaginary, well, whatever you want. You can share some of my cake, actually. I've got so much cake and hot dogs lying around and apricots. You can have one of those. So you wouldn't want this one. This one looks a little bit sticky. Next hymn is O Worship the King, O Glorious Above. O gratefully sing his power and his love. I have a feeling that this is related to one of the questions from last week's quiz. So again, if you stick around until after Virtual Church, until later on, we'll give you the answers. Okay, so let's go. Jay, Patreon, and Phil, another patron, two patrons requesting this wonderful tune. It's called Hanover, and we'll have four verses. O Worship the King, O Glorious Above. Thank you. four verses. That I hope that was enough for you. I worship the King, O glorious above, O richly sing his power and his love. For Jay and Phil. Now, it is Christ the King, okay? Now, I'm just going to play something which may not be always associated with Christ the King. Actually, it's normally a Christmas chorale. It is just, it's just one page worth, and it's actually J.S. Bach's almost like a little organ fanfare interlude. It's Von Himmel hoch da komme ich, from heaven on high I come. Again, it's normally Christmas, but I imagine Christ coming out of the sky, coming out of heaven with his glorious crown. This lasts about maybe 45 seconds, but it's rather fun actually. Let's just find a really suitable Baroque sound. Let's just get some mixtures fired up. No reeds in this one. I'm using most mixtures across all the divisions here, as well as one or two mutations. There we go. So, von Himmel hoch, da komme ich her. Yeah, I told you it was about 45 seconds long. What I used to do when I was playing in various cathedrals, well, I still do, when I had a cathedral full-time post at Winchester, around Christmas time, Christmas Day or Midnight Mass, I would play that just after the Gospel on as brighter sounds I could possibly sum up on the organ. And it was just the right length, just the right sort of you know, feeling and mood for Christmas. It used to be played at the end of Carols from Kings as well. They play something else now, I think, the end of Carols from Kings, but that always used to be the short voluntary on the television. And on the radio, they would go into a big voluntary afterwards. A little bit like virtual church, two voluntaries. That isn't where I got the idea from, actually. Next hymn here from Andantino, which I am under strict orders to play cheerfully, is Since Jesus Came Into My Heart. That's its title. I'll just try and read it because it's extremely old print, this. What a wonderful change in my life has been wrought since Jesus came into my heart. I have light in my soul which so long I had sought, since Jesus came into my heart. Okay, so then it goes into a chorus with a pause mark on the first note of the chorus. Okay, so let's see what we can do with this. And Antino, thank you very much for requesting this. Thank you very much, Anne, for requesting that. I didn't know that one from Adam. I'd never heard it before in my life. But it's rather fun. I think it can only be played in a cheerful way, that one. Can't imagine it being done in any other way. I'm just curious by the pause mark on the first note of the refrain, though. I just wonder how you meant to coordinate that with a full church. Okay, the next hymn here is Sing Praise to God Who Reigns Above, the God of all creation, the God of power, the God of love, the God of our salvation. Mit Freudensart is the name of the tune. Can't quite see who wrote the tune. I think it must be from a collection. It looks like it's from a collection from the 16th century from Berlin. Dennis, who is one of our patrons, I've been saying that word a lot today. It's great to have you in the chat. Thank you very much for joining us today. Dennis has requested this. Thank you very much. Okay. It's three verses. This looks like a wonderful, wonderful harmonization as well. So here we go. Dennis, sing praise to God who reigns above. Just as I thought, it is a good tune. It just looks like a strong tune, good harmony, goes in all the right directions. So thank you very much, Dennis, for requesting that. Sorry about my funny note at the end there in the penultimate bar. In the last bar, actually. Last bar of the whole piece, I played a wrong note. Sorry about that. I owe you an F sharp. Okay, let's crack on to Guiding Power. Christ triumphant, ever reigning, Saviour, Master, King, Lord of heaven, our lives sustaining, hear us as we sing. Peter, I think, who goes by the name of Digital Worship Band, thank you very much for just becoming a patron. Peter has requested this. The music is by John Barnard. It's called Guiding Power. It's wonderful. Most of you should know this. It's terrific. I think we're five verses. It says turn over for verse 5. Oh, it's just a descant. I'm not going to sing it to you. Okay, here we go. This is a really uplifting one, this. I suppose it's the last time. I know when we go into Advent, just things start to just tone down a little bit, don't they? The anticipation of waiting and watching before we get into Christmas. So let's sort of get it out of our systems before we go into Advent next week. Christ triumphant, ever reigning, Saviour, Master, King. Thank you very much, Jan, for your donation just now. That's very kind of you. Thank you very much indeed. I know not why God's wondrous grace to me he hath made known, nor why unworthily Christ in love redeemed me for his own. But I know whom I have believed. I am persuaded that he is able to. Second page. Keep, that he is able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day. So good job I actually did that, because I would have not have picked up the second page. That would have been a bit awkward. So thank you very much to Tom, who is a Patreon, and obviously Trevor as well, both Patreons.
Trevor just donated, sorry.
Oh, Trevor just donated. Sorry. Right. Thank you very much, Trevor. Magical voice just came out of the heavens there. Okay, so thank you very much, guys. Thank you for everything. Thank you for requesting, thank you for donating, and thank you for joining me. Let's crack on. Four verses. Now, I didn't know this, but apparently some fishermen have been lost, are currently lost at sea in Sussex. I'm not sure what sea that would be in Sussex. Well, and where that is, I don't know, but
Solent.
It's, yes, but I don't quite know whereabouts. Solent is, well, it's fairly, it's quite hard to get lost in the Solent, isn't it? So I don't know any detail, but I think some fishermen are lost, possibly in the Solent, possibly, they don't know whereabouts, in the south of England, that is. So Rob has asked for, and it's very appropriate, for Eternal Father Strong to save. The tune is Melita. Every verse, apart from the final verse, ends with the line, "For those in peril on the sea." Oh, here is when we cry to thee, for those in peril on the sea. Let's hope they're not in peril. Let's just hope that they've had a, you know, power cut on their boat and they can't communicate. Hopefully everything will be okay. Fingers crossed for those guys. So Rob has asked for this hymn in memory, in honour, in praise, in hope, all of that sort of stuff for these fishermen down in the south, in the south of the south coast of England. Let's hope those guys get home safely. Now we'll have just a few more things just as what's going to happen over the next 15 minutes or so. I'm going to have a hymn here. This is one of the best hymns. It's actually for Palm Sunday, but it's a, you know, it's definitely has a Christ the King feel to it. We'll then have a voluntary. And then what we'll do is we'll actually go through the questions and the answers to the quiz. So if you took part in that, or actually if you'd like to go through the questions you didn't take part, if you'd like to try and work them out as we go through them, stick around. Okay, so we'll go through that after the voluntary. So we'll go straight into the voluntary after this. It's very appropriate for Christ the King. And if you're very lucky, if I can find some inspiration after the quiz questions, I might just play something else just to send you on your way. So here we go. This is, all glory, Lord, and honour to the Redeemer King.
Thank you.
That's Crown Imperial, of course, William Walton. What better piece to play on Christ the King than Crown Imperial? Such a wonderful piece. Terrific. I just wish I had more time to set it up and get the registrations the way I want them to be. The shamar came on and the wrong place again. I don't know why the shamar keeps coming on, but I pressed buttons that really ought not to engage the shamar. It's really odd. Hauptwerk is a really quirky thing, you know. Okay, so let's get on to the quiz answers. So, if Caroline can pass me the questions, so I know what the questions are. They're on that side. Brilliant. Okay.
Sam's
right. Sam. Sam's in. Hello, Sam. Made it just in time, my dear boy. Made it just in time. Okay, so I hope you have your answers ready and you're ready to follow them. This will be fun. This will be a lot of fun, this. I've been looking forward to this bit for a long time. Okay, so question number one last week was... By the way, if anyone has just joined and wanting and they're expecting hymns and wondering what on earth is going on now, last week we had a quiz, okay? During last week's virtual church, I just asked questions throughout the virtual church and said to everyone watching, I'll give you the answers next week. Put your answers in the comment on the video and we'll go through the answers next week and when I will announce a winner. And actually, it was a lot of fun. It actually was really, really an interesting way just to spice things up in the virtual church world. So here are the answers to last week's quiz. Question number one was, what words are commonly sung to the tune Hanover? Well, we had it tonight, didn't we? We had it tonight. Of course it is. Worship the King. Okay, now what we will allow is if you put ye servants of God, that's allowed as well. Okay, so a point to one of those. Question number two was, from which famous piece of music does this piece come? Oh, let me get some stops out. So, of course, the first movement of Beethoven's Sixth Symphony, known as a Pastoral Symphony. Wonderful piece. It's like program music. Later on in the symphony, he depicts a storm getting closer and closer and closer in the middle of the storm, and then it dies away. It's wonderful music, that Pastoral Symphony. It's one of the best. Question number three was, on most French organs, which division is on the lowest manual? It's the main manual. It's a grand orgue. It's what we call the great, right? So in France, that one is on the bottom manual. Catches people out, actually. And in Germany, it's different again. But anyway, we'll go into that another time. So the grand orgue. How many divisions does the organ of Westminster Abbey have? Well, let me just pop something on the screen and we'll quickly talk about this. So on the screen now is the specification for the Abbey. Now, I asked specifically about this organ because I knew, there's basically a secret division to it. All right. So on the organ, on the screen, you've got the pedal organ on the screen and in the triforium. That's actually one division. I'm counting that as one division, okay? Choir organ has two divisions. It has an upper division, which is enclosed, which is basically in a swell box, and then a lower division, which is enclosed, okay? So that's two there. Great, swell, solo, and then bombard. Right, so you've got one, pedal, one, two, choir, has three there, four, great, five, swell, 6 solo, 7 bombard. But there is another division. There's another division which is not actually currently connected to the organ. It was disconnected in the 1930s. I think it was the 30s. And it is a celestial organ. Okay, so I think it's in the North Transept, North Transept's Triforium area, and it's not connected to the organ at all. So actually the answer is 8. 8 divisions.
I don't think anyone got that question right.
Ooh, hard luck, hard luck. Question 5 is, how many verses are produced for All the Saints? Well, it's 8, of course, you all know that one. We have that one quite a lot. What cadence does Vidor's Toccata end with? Well, let me demonstrate that. So you have this, it's high F, followed by an F major 7 here. Going to B flat major, so that's chord 4. And then he raises the 4th and adds a 5th to it, sorry, a 6th to it as well. So actually a plagal cadence with an added major augmented 4th and 6th, like this. Question 7. From which hymn come the words, that the powers of hell may vanish as darkness clears away? You all know that one. Let all mortal flesh keep silence. Picardy. 8. From which hymn does this alto line come? I played this to you. Now you altos should know this. I know there's enough altos in the chat. Now if I add the context around it, listen, it's so obvious. All of you should have got that right. The next one, number 9, it's the same sort of question, but from which tune does this tenor line come? I played this. Just think about the time signature. Think about the time signature. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You'll kick yourself, because it's simple. Question 10, I think more people got this one right. From which hymn tune does this bass line come? I gave you this. You all know it, I'm sure. It's this. Question 11 was for the organ geeks. So if I play a middle C on the organ with a Nazar 2 and 2 thirds, which pitch do you hear? What pitch do you hear? I played this. This is middle C. That's not a C, is it? It's 12 notes above that, which is a G. That one. So let me change the camera so you can see. What I'll do is, because the microphone goes off, the The left hand will play the middle C with the Nazard, and then the right hand will play the G that the pitch is sounding. Make sense? So it's actually 12 notes above. The Nazard is sometimes called a 12th for that reason. It's 12 notes above it sounds. It's the mutation. So you have that, that's middle C. And then with the 12th or the Nazard, so it plays at the 5th, basically. Well done to those of you who got that right. Which descant is this? Let's try and remember it. Descant by David Wilcott's Glory. Most of you got that right. From which piece does this come? This was 3 points, this one. So I wanted composer and title of the piece, its nickname, and why it has earned its nickname. J.S. Bach, his fugue in E minor from the Prelude and Fugue in E minor, BWV 548. Its nickname is the wedge. If you imagine a wedge, a door wedge or a wedge of cheese or something, or imagine like a crescendo, which starts at nothing and then grows and grows like that. Okay, imagine that sort of wedge shape. Fugue starts on a single note, which is the beginning of the wedge. And then as the fugue develops, the wedge expands, the intervals get bigger. There. Bigger. All the way to an octave. That's why it's called the wedge. From which hymn does this chamade moment appear? Tonight we opened with it. It is Rejoice the Lord is King, a wonderful tune by Handel. Who composed this hymn tune? Well, it was Samuel Sebastian Wesley, and it's called Hereford. I just need to find this. Okay, now, which Noel Rawsthorne last verse arrangement is this? This is what I played. Divine or Love's Excelling. Which stop on the Rotterdam organ is this? I played one stop and it was like this. It's the quint, 8 foot. Some of you got that right. Well done, those who got it right. Now, this is rather fun, this one. Which cathedral in the UK has the longest echo? Now, I've prepared some scientific evidential videos. There'll be a bit of arguing about this, and there already has been some very opinionated answers to this one. So let's see, let's just demonstrate the echo of Rotterdam, Barvo Kirk in the St. Lawrence Kirk in Rotterdam has an echo like this. You may want to turn down your hi-fis, or up if you want to have a loud blast. Think about your neighbours. This is the echo of St. Lawrence Kirk. This is the echo of Liverpool Cathedral here in the UK. Pretty good, right? Pretty good. This is the echo of St. Paul's Cathedral here in the UK. So, is that the answer? It's St. Paul's Cathedral here in the UK. Now what I did is I found, obviously, C major chord. First one was played by Ian Tracy. I found the loudest piece of music I could in C major. And the second piece was John Scott, the final chord of Liszt's Ad Nos on full organ, including the Royal Trumpets on the West Wall. And I think from that experiment, you know, I tried to turn up the volume as much as I could. You should see that St. Paul's is the answer. Sorry, John and Francis. Listen again, he's Liverpool. And here's St. Paul's. There you go. Scientific evidence. There has to be St. Paul's, right? So unfortunately, I haven't got the picture anymore. In fact, you can just see it. Gosh, if you look very, very carefully on your screen in the top right-hand corner now. That's everything's backwards. The picture is Romsey Abbey in Hampshire. Beautiful, beautiful Norman church. If you're ever in Hampshire, make sure you go and check Romsey Abbey out. And then the final question, which was actually a bit of a, in case there was a draw, but actually there wasn't a draw. The Fitbit, last week, how many did it show that I did? Where is it? Oh, yeah, so the Fitbit actually was 2,919 steps that I did while sat still. So this Fitbit actually was counting all the times I sort of moved my left wrist. Okay, so here, so I'd say that's out of, well, 20, let's not include the last question because it was a bit of a curveball in case there was a tie. So 19 points in total. Actually, question the wedge question, I did say there were three points to that one. So actually, we have 21 points here. So, in third place, I am very happy to say that. But we've counted all these answers up, and if you want to insist on a recount, then please do. we have to be open and transparent. But I'm going to say that in third place we have Samuel Sleeth. Well done, Sam. Well done. I particularly liked your answer around the echoes. Interestingly, my timings were different to what your echoes, your numbers were, the echoes. But well done, Sam. Bravo. There it is, I see. Sam said that Liverpool has 11 seconds, but depends on wind pressure. It does. So if you played just a measly little flute like this, as opposed to a big old there's going to be a difference. And anyway, so Sam, excellent work there. Second place, with a very respectable score, is Andantino. Well done, Anne. Second place. That's to be proud. Very, very good. Very, very good indeed. I have to make these quizzes harder. First place. And I can't say that I'm surprised. Actually, I knew this person would do well. This person always does well when it comes to questions around hymns, and this person is a proper choral music geek. They don't come better informed than Francis Williams. Francis Williams came first. Well done, Francis. To be honest with you, Francis, if you didn't come first, I would have been disappointed. So there we go. Well done, Sam. Well done, Anne. And well done, Francis. Larry, if you're in the chat, do you now know what a Fitbit is? Oh. So Nala's going to say well done as well. Well done. Well done. He's clapping up. Can't really hear it, but she's purring as well. Well, there we go. I hope you've enjoyed that tonight. I hope you enjoyed the quiz last week. And well done to those who took part. Some questions were obviously easier than others, but I tried to include some hard ones and some easy ones. I do have a Christmas quiz lined up for you in the coming weeks, and that one actually is rather challenging, so you might want to work in teams with that. I don't know, we'll work that one out. Next week is Advent. Can't quite believe it's Advent already. It doesn't seem like it's just gone past April or May. This year has been such a blur. So something big for next week, I think. First Sunday of Advent. Let's make it a big one next week. So until next week.
Francis is in the chat.
Yes.
Made an appearance.
Hello, Francis. We'll say cheerio. Caroline, thank you very much, Caroline, for all of your hard work in the live chat. Thank you to Nala for not destroying the set. And Bobby, who hasn't been around, actually. So until next time, whenever that will be, find my button, we will say cheerio. Good night, everyone. Thank you very much for joining me. Please become a patron if you haven't already. If not, please make a donation. Thank you very much, everyone. Good night.